Good afternoon. Hello, family and friends. How are you guys doing today? I'm back with another video. Right now, I just want to talk about my story because there's so many parts to it, but I'm going to give you a little bit of it. I'm sitting here eating Chinese food, Jennifer Star's chicken. And I'm just gonna talk to you guys for a few minutes or two. This will be my third video today. My second video will be airing at 3 p.m. today. So I ask you guys to please take all mistakes with love. God is a wonderful God. Yes, He is. On Thursday, I hosted the prayer line for my family line. And I tell you, God came in and blessed my soul. On Friday, I had to go to the doctor. And I had an 8:30 appointment. I really had two doctor's appointments, which was my doctor's appointment in the morning, and then I had a 3 o'clock appointment in the afternoon for a mammogram. But I thank God because I did even go to the second appointment. But because of that, it's because I felt dizzy that morning, but I pressed my way to go to the doctor anyway. So it probably was that I didn't have nothing to eat. So I went on to the doctor, and on my way coming back from the doctor, the transportation people picked me up, and as we was driving and stuff, she was upset with her boss. But then while she was talking to me and another lady, she didn't see the car that was coming on her side while we was coming out the street. So while she was running her mouth for stuff, the car was driving fast. And I said, Jesus, I tell you guys, it's power in the name of Jesus. And as I began to say that, the car eased up and it almost tore us up. But that lets you know that when you're chosen by God, and when it's not your time to go, you're not going anywhere. But you have something to do. And I tell you, I thank God that when I left home that morning, I prayed. I always pray and ask God to be the driver of the car, of that person. I always ask God to rebuke all accidents in the name of Jesus. And I ask God to shield and protect me, cover me under His blood. Allow no harm or dangers come upon me. And I ask God to take me to my destination and bring me back home safely. And He does it every time. So I thank God for Jesus. Because you know what? People don't realize life is so short today. Every time you turn around, somebody getting shot up. So every time you turn around, something is going this way. Something going that way. We losing loved ones all the way around us. We losing people that we don't even know. But when we listen to their stories, it feel like we have a connection with them because we can identify. Some of their stories we can identify. I know the part with getting shot, I can identify because in 1989, I was shot. It was me, my ex-husband, and my brother-in-law in a car. And my brother-in-law was shot 3 times. I was shot once in the back. But I tell you, God is a good God. Because even in the midst of me talking and stuff like that, when I got to the hospital and stuff like that, I tell you, before I even went underneath the knife, I prayed. Because I know if I die, I will bust hell wide open. It wouldn't have been nobody's fault but mine's. Because I was raised upright. You know, sometimes we get off on the wrong track. Yes, a lot of us was raised up in church. Yes. And when you start talking about the Lord, the first thing people say, well, I'm going to church. I don't care if you'll never go to church. Just come to Jesus. That's who you come to, and let him direct you. Let him order your steps, you know. And I praise God, because even in the midst of me, you know, getting shot, you know what I'm saying? I thought I was on my way to hell. When God gave me the vision of hell, and I was getting ready to go in there, and I began to pray, and I asked God to please just give me another chance, and I'll tell it wherever I would go. I was on drugs real bad, and I asked God for a second chance, and he gave me exactly that. And I tell you, I've been running for my life. But yes, I slipped and I fell. You know what I'm saying? I still didn't, it didn't stop there. But everywhere I went, I talked about Jesus Christ. And I remember being in a coma or asleep. I could hear my mother saying, all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them according to his purpose. I remember my mama saying that. They had me tied up on the bed so I couldn't move because the machine was breathing for me. But I could hear my mother saying that. I could hear different ones around me praying for me. And I could hear my mother saying, God ain't finished with her yet. She got work to do. I heard my mother's voice. And mommy, if you listen to me right now, I love you. God knows I love you. And I'm so glad that God brought our relationship closer together like never before. I truly am a firm believer that God will fix your life. He will turn your midnight into day. Hallelujah. He will turn your mess into a message. I got a message to tell y'all, that the same God that delivered me can deliver you. He don't have no respect of person. I want you to know that Jesus loves us, because he went to the cross and he died for your sins and my sins, that we may live with him in eternity. But I tell you, honey, he took all excuses to the cross. So we don't have no excuses why we ain't doing what we need to do, because God took it to the cross. Hallelujah. So guess what? He said, case dismissed, saved by grace. Jesus dropped the charges over 2,000 years ago. And I want you to know, if it wasn't for Jesus going to that cross, we all would have been lost. And I'm so glad that he didn't come down from the cross. Hallelujah. He thought about me when I was on drugs real bad. He thought about me when I was out there prostituting and doing things I ain't had none. He wanted to feel what we was going through. I'm so glad that he stayed on the cross. Guess what? Because you know what? Now they're killing up the black people. And they turn around saying Black Lives Matter. But we killing each other. So how you going to say Black Lives Matter when y'all each other is killing each other? Let me tell you something. Jesus knows what we went through. He felt the pain. At any given time, he could have came from that cross to save himself. But because he didn't, because he loved us, and he stayed on that cross just for you and me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I tell you, I thank God for salvation today. Let me tell you something. I didn't have to pay for salvation. Salvation is free. Who the Son set free is free indeed. And I praise God for his word, because guess what? I don't have to take your word. But I tell you, when you get in the word and get to know who God is in your life, I tell you, God began to deliver me. God began to change my mindset. God began to change my life. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. God is so good. When I tell you, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. Hallelujah. I'm a firm believer that he will save you. I'm a firm believer that he will deliver you, because he delivered me. Yeah, he removed drugs and alcohol out my life. And December the 13th, I have 12 years clean, uninterrupted. That means when I came in Narcotics Anonymous, I didn't look back. And when I did look back, I looked back and see how far God brought me. God brought me from a mighty long way. On November the 13th, I have 11 years clean from cigarettes. When I tell you, God delivered me. Because every time I try to stop, when somebody made me mad, I went back to it. But I tell you, the scripture said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. And he is good, y'all. Because guess what? I always knew that God was my way out. I already knew already. And all I had to do was come to him. All I had to do was surrender to him. All I had to do was say, Lord, forgive me. I am your God. Only you could deliver me because I can't do it by myself. I can't make it without you. And I was sick and tired. I've been sick and tired of my own self. I was miserable. I messed up my life. But I came in Narcotics Anonymous at the age of 48. July the 25th, I'll be 60. And nobody can tell me God ain't good to me. Yes, he is. I know he delivered me. I know he changed my life. 2019, I moved to North Carolina. God opened the door for my Section 8. And let me tell you something. God, not knowing that, God has something more in store for me. And I tell you, God delivered me. God saved me. And he set me free. And he baptized me with the Holy Ghost coming up out the water. And I've been running for my life. Yes, things have not been easy. Yes, I had some crying days. And I had some trying days. And I tell you, the devil is still barking up the tree. But I want him to know today, he is a liar and a father of all lies. And he gonna have his part in the lake of fire one day. Because the God that I serve loves us. He changes us. And I'm excited about it. I ain't half stepping. I don't play games when it comes to my salvation and my recovery. Before I lose my salvation and my recovery, I will cut you off. And I will cut that one off. For me to live and to die is gain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I tell you, I love the Lord, and I won't take it back. I love the Lord. I'm so glad that he loves me first. He loved me before the foundation of the world, before I entered into my mother's womb. He loved me. He prayed for me before I ever was in the making. He sees everything. He knows everything. He's still in control. Two things that God didn't tell us in the Word of God. He didn't tell us how we was going to leave here. Just be ready. Our time is always ready. He didn't tell us how we going to reap what we sow. Don't get it twisted because you say you think I'm saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. And that I don't reap some of the things that I did when I was out there in sin. Believe me, I do. But it's a different when you reap it in Christ Jesus. I'd rather reap it in Christ Jesus than a reaper not know who he is. I'm grateful, y'all. I'm sitting here thanking God for the many blessings that he restored upon my life. And I'm talking about the Word of God. That's what I'm talking about. See, I don't. Materialistic, it's a blessing. But the blessing is getting closer to God. And to stay in his Word. Where he can teach you. He could deliver you. He could turn you around. And he take your mess. And he turned it into a message. I'm here to tell you that if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'm here to tell you Jesus is waiting with his arms open wide. He's willing to supply all your needs in your life. Take my advice. Don't let this moment pass you by. I love you. God bless you. Any mistakes, I ask you to take it in love. If nobody told you that they didn't love you, Jesus loves you. I love you. And you have a blessed, wonderful day. And to all the birthdays around the globe, I'm going to leave you with this song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. May the good Lord bless 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 you. And many more. Happy birthday to everyone that's celebrating a birthday in the month of July. Love you guys. Stay safe. And God bless you.